searching for many of the same things. They're searching for how they can be authentic in the workforce, how they can have better work-life balance.
I'm happy that in the APAC region, where there's a great amount of culture of women coming into work, I'm very happy that we'll be climbing that and achieving those numbers much ahead of the curve and hopefully contributing to a larger cause as well.
It's hard for a woman to say, well, from now on I'm going to be more open and I'm going to change my organisation. It has to really come from the company to make it more acceptable.
Again, I have been very vocal on championing this, and my answer to this is so easy. What women are doing is national service.
There are many men in this room with lots of power and influence, and many more beyond these walls. You're in a unique position to do cutting-edge work, not only in the business world, but throughout society, to work in partnership with women and other committed men that takes the struggle for gender equality to the next level. Each of us has to decide our own answer to the question, what is the legacy we want to leave behind in the short time we have on this earth? And then we need to get to work. Thank you very much.
The fact is that men need gender balance as well. It's about quality of life. It's about paternal leave, which we talked about earlier. It's about work-life balance. It's about freedom to be who it is you want to be.
But my challenge to myself and my challenge to all the men in the audience is how do we take what we've learned tonight and apply it in our day-to-day lives? I love what Jackson said. Do we have the courage to do this every day?
What I wanted to do was to show you that the existing paradigm I have is truly universal and can help us see that the project that we are all trying to pursue, whether we are women or whether we are men, is a collective quest for greater authenticity in work and beyond. Thank you.